Hi, I'm Sebastian Chavez. Welcome to this quick video to help you explain latent tuberculosis infection, or latent TB, to your patients. I'm here with Dr. Shireen Kotruk, an infectious disease physician. Dr. Kotruk, thank you for joining us.
Thanks, Sebastian. It's good to be here.
So let me ask you, why should somebody get treated for latent tuberculosis, especially if they feel fine?
Most people with a risk factor for latent TB and with a positive TB test should really be treated after they've been evaluated for active disease with a symptom screen and a chest x-ray. People with latent TB don't feel sick, but TB germs can hide and then become active, causing TB disease, a serious illness, years after the initial infection. In the United States, actually most of our TB disease comes from people who've had progression of a latent infection. So latent TB medicines can prevent TB disease from developing and from spreading to other people.
Okay, but doesn't the treatment for latent tuberculosis take a long time?
TB germs are slow growing, so they take some time to kill. But we now have treatment options for latent TB as short as 3 or 4 months.
And what if somebody's worrying about the side effects of the treatment?
I tell people, generally the risk of getting TB disease is greater than the risk of having a serious side effect from latent TB medicines. We'll watch you closely during your treatment, and if needed, we can always stop or change your medications.
Well, Dr. Kotruk, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
So tell your patients with latent tuberculosis that treatment can prevent their infection from creating TB disease and from spreading to others. Treatment options can be as short as 3 months, and side effects can be managed. Thanks for watching.